fact about the New Zealand. Number one, they have a Maori as is a native people. Number two, they have the most 50 active volcano all year round. Number three, New Zealanders have a three official language, which is English, Sign Language, and the Maori. Number four, they call the New Zealand people as a Kiwi people. And number five, the most country with more sheep than the people. And number six, the town with the longest name in the world. Lastly, the first country with universal suffrage, which the vote for women was approved since 1893.
Makariki is a celebration to mark the end of the year and a new beginning. Makariki is quite similar to Ramadan because the date cycle won't be the same every year. It all depends on the natural occurrence. And in this case, we use stars instead of the moon. This celebration also welcomes a warm season for the farmers to gain a hefty harvest. As for the social ethic and protocol, there are many things that differ from Malaysia. One of them is smoking policy. In New Zealand, people rarely smoke and it is really hard to see them waving their cigarette in the public. Next, the New Zealanders always dress casually yet neat. There is no fixed dress code for them to wear at the workplace. It is enough for them to wear appropriate attire that covers the important parts.
For good business with New Zealanders, a few considerations is a must. While having a business meeting with New Zealanders, try to be punctual. Make appointments beforehand, introduce each other by exchanging business cards even during informal introductions, try to break the ice before starting the official meeting, uphold the facts and figures during negotiations, put forth realistic figures without playing with prices, to be fair, focus on win-win situation, consider to be as honest as possible, be realistic in delivering ideas, and also practice gift-giving as a symbol of gratitude towards them. Things need to be avoided when having business with them, such as do not delaying during meetings, avoid sudden meetings, avoid intruding in their private life, do not be too informal in meetings, do not make the business environment too informal, avoid using power positions, do not use bargaining tactics during negotiations, do not use high-pressure strategies, avoid delivering ambiguous informations. Do not give over-aggressive or unrealistic proposal ideas. Do not make promises which is hard to be kept. And do not at all give gifts before a meeting as it shows a sign of bribery.
In good Hofstad cultural dimension, they have six cultural dimensions that been used to analysis between of home and host country, which is power distance, individualism, masculinity, uncertainty avoidance, and long-term avoidance. Firstly, for power distance, we can see Malaysia have higher score than New Zealand, which shows Malaysia accept hierarchical order where everybody has a place which need no further evocation. For individualism, New Zealand score 79 and Malaysia score 26. So New Zealand is on individualist culture, while Malaysia is more to collectivism society. Next is masculinity, that shown New Zealand masculine society with score 58. This is because New Zealand are proud of their achievement. For the fourth dimension is uncertainty avoidance. Uncertainty avoidance means the culture that feel threatened by ambiguous or unknown situation. In this case, Malaysia score 36, which shown that low preference for avoiding uncertainty. Finally, is long-term orientation dimension, which Malaysia and New Zealand have low score that determine both countries are normative countries.